Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. So yesterday we have discussed about the topology, type of topology. The next topic in this module, the first module, is the network models. So network computer networks are created by different entities. So network computers networks are created by different entities. So standards are needed so that these heterogeneous network can communicate with each other. So we know that our computer or mobile phone, there are so many different heterogeneous networks are there. To communicate between these heterogeneous network, we have to build a standard. So the best known standards are OSI model and internet model. So the OSI model means open system interconnection model defines a 7-layer network, and internet model defines a 5-layer network. So the categories of networks are, today when we speak of network, we are generally referring to primary models, local area networks and wide area networks, that means LAN and WAN. The category into which a network falls is determined by its size. So this local area network and wide area networks are classified because of its size. So if it is size is very less, means when an office come to an office or a school system, we use local area network. So such a mean the categories are introduced because of its size. So a LAN normally covers are less than 2 meters. A WAN can be worldwide. Networks of a size in between are normally referred to as metropolitan area, that is means MAN, network of span of 10 miles. So LAN is less than 2 meters, WAN is worldwide. In between LAN and WAN, it is called a metropolitan area. So the first one is local area network, LAN. A local area network, LAN, is usually privately owned and linked the devices in a single office building or campus. Depending on the needs of an organization and the type of technology used, a LAN can be as simple as 2 PCs and a printer someone home office, or it can extend throughout a company and include audio and video peripherals. Currently LAN size is limited to few kilometers. LANs are designed to allow resources to be shared between personal computers and workstation. So LAN is introduced to allow resources to be shared between personal computers or workstation. The resources to be shared can include hardware such as printer, software and application program, or data. So the resources are hardware, software and data. In addition to size, LANs are distinguished from other types of network by their transmission media and topology. So according to transmission media and topology, LANs are distinguished. In general, a given LAN will use one type of transmission medium. The most common LAN topologies are bus, ring and star. So early LANs had a bitrate or data rate up to 4 to 16 megabits per second range. Today, however, speeds are normally 100 or 1000 MB per second. Wireless LANs are the newest evolution of LAN technology. So the next one is wide area network, WAN. A wide area network WAN provide a long distance transmission of data, image, audio and video information world. We normally refer to the first as a switched WAN and the second as a point to point WAN. So there is two type of classification for WAN. One is switched WAN and another one is point to point WAN. The switched WAN connects the end system, usually comprise a router, internet networking connection device that connects another LANs or WAN. So there is a switched WAN connect the end system, usually comprise a router and connect to a LAN or WAN. For switched WAN, example is asynchronous transmission mode network, ATM. The point-to-point WAN normally a line leased from a telephone or cable TV provider that connects a home computer or a small LAN to an internet service provider, ISP. So in switched WAN, it connects the end system using a router. That's example is asynchronous transfer mode ATM network. And point to point WAN normally leased line from telephone or cable TV that connected a home computer or a small LAN to an internet service provider ISP. This type of WAN often used to provide internet access. So this type of WAN used to provide internet access. An early example of switched WAN is X.25 as a network designed to provide connectivity between end users. X.25 is being gradually replaced by high speed and more efficient network called frame relay. So and another example for WAN is wireless WAN. So the first figure shows the switched WAN and second figure shows the point to point WAN. So the X means that it's a router connection. The end systems are connected through a router. And that figure shows the switched WAN. Second one is point to point WAN, a computer and the modem. computer is connected using a modem and point to point man and modem through the ISP. The ISP is connect, ISPs are connected through the modems. So there is a point to point WAN. And the third one is metropolitan area network. A metropolitan area network MAN is a network within the with a size between LAN and WAN. So it normally covers the area inside a town or city. It is designed for customer who need high speed connectivity. Normally to the internet, we have endpoints spread over the city or parts of city. So it is designed for MAN is designed for the customer who need high speed connectivity. A good example of MAN is the part of the telephone company network that can provide high speed DSL line to the customer. Another example is TV network, cable TV network that originally was designed for cable TV but today can also be used for high speed data connection between the networks. The next one is interconnection of networks, internetwork. Today it is very rare to see LAN, a MAN or a LAN in isolation. They are connected to one another. When two or more networks are connected, they become an internetwork or internet. So the figure shows that interconnection of these networks, LAN, MAN, WAN, etc. So there is a bus topology in this side and a hub and a star topology in here. And there is a point-to-point WAN and switched WAN and a point-to-point WAN there. Here is a point-to-point WAN and there is a point-to-point WAN here and there is a another system. So this is a internetwork, that is or internet. So it's an interconnection of networks, LAN, MAN and etc. are called internetworks. So that's all about today's class. We have discussed the networks, categories of networks such as MAN, LAN, WAN. And the another one is internet. Interconnection of networks is called internet. So that's all about this section. And thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and like, share, comment. And thank you.